Are you having a hard time leveling the bed on your Ender 3? Does it wobble? Or are the springs, one's really loose, one's really tight? Yeah, that could be the problem. I'll show you how to fix it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. Now, when you got your Ender 3, it came like this. It came with the base all assembled, and then you add the pieces going up. So what you do is make sure that all the wires are out of place, and then check it. It shouldn't rock right now, and then you know you have it right. And then we'll add the uprights. Well, on this one, the base was never right. So first we need to loosen these side screws and also the uprights so we can level it and then retighten everything. I'll lay the Ender 3 on its side, and then I'll loosen the screws that hold the uprights. Next, I'll loosen the screws on the side of the base. Then we're ready to adjust. So now the four upright screws are loose and the side screws are loose. And so now when I try to rock this, it doesn't rock. So now I need to tighten these side screws while it's flat, and then we'll tighten the screws that hold the uprights. First, I tighten the screws on the sides and get these nice and snug. I like to clamp a square to the upright so I know everything is nice and straight. And then I'll flip it on its side and tighten the screws that hold those uprights. After that, I'll take the clamps off, and I know everything's square. Now that we've got the machine flat and square, we can look at the real problem. And that's the X carriage right here. One side is lower than the other, and the side that's lower is the side where the springs are squished. In fact, I took out my caliper and measured from the top to that bar, and it's 3 millimeters higher on this side than it is on this side. Now, I wish there was an easy way to adjust this. There are adjustable wheels, but you can only do so much. There's two screws right here that control the position of this arm. And that's when you assemble it. This is the assembly you get, which is right here. And you have to bolt this cross beam to it. And it pivots around a screw head, and then there's two screws that you tighten. And if those screws are off a little bit, that other end is moving a lot. And getting this right is not easy, but it's easier to do it when you assemble it, because right now I got to take all this apart to get to those screws. So I'm going to take this apart and I'm going to adjust it and see if I can get this guy to be level or at least slightly higher on this side because of the weight of this thing coming over in the brackets. I'm going to get some sag. So slightly higher over here would not bother me. And I'm talking only like a half a millimeter, but that's what we're going to do next. Take this off, take the lead screw off, take these top screws and take this bar off so we can get this whole assembly off. I've taken the lead screw off, I've taken the top bar off, I've disconnected the motor wires, and now I can lift this carriage off. Now it runs up and down just fine, but I can take it off and there's two holes here that access the screws that hold this arm in place. So with an Allen wrench, I can come in here and loosen these guys and try to adjust this and then slip it over and test it. Measure it and see if I can get close to level. So here's the two access holes. Here's the first one. I'm going to loosen this and I'm going to keep this one loose until I'm done. And then the second one, which is the more important one, is right here next to the motor. I'll loosen this up, then I'm going to twist this thing, and you can barely see it, but it feels like I'm moving it a lot. So I'm pushing as far as I can up in the direction I want, and then I'm going to tighten that first one. It took me three tries, but I did get it. There are two screws that I loosened. I only tightened the inner one. And that way I could pivot the bar, tighten it, test it, loosen it, move it. So three tries, and I almost had to take it to its max. And then once I got it set, then I went back and tightened the second screw. And it shifted it just a little, but not enough to worry about. And I did put the threaded rod in so I could check it at multiple points. And I am a half a millimeter lower on this side than this side. Just exactly what I wanted. So now there's a couple things I want to do before we put this back together. Let me show you that. So the next step is I installed this top bar. I put all four screws in, but I didn't tighten it. And sometimes this can be hard to put in. If you can't get these to line up, then you might have to loosen the screws underneath again and re-square everything. But it should still bolt in place if everything is right. So I got them in, but they're not tight. They're just finger tight. Now I take this arm and I can lift it and see how smooth it moves. Now there is an eccentric nut just on this side back here behind the bar. This is the only one you have adjustment to. I loosen this guy up so it just spins because I want these outer wheels to move smoothly. And once I feel that it's moving smoothly, I'll hold it up like this and then I'll tighten these guys. And then I'll adjust this eccentric wheel to just ride so it starts to spin. And that stops any side-to-side movement. So there, now I've got it tight and it moves pretty smooth. Now I just need to adjust this eccentric wheel. That's pretty good right there. So I got a nice smooth movement. So now we can install the threaded rod. And now reinstall the threaded rod. And what I like to do is bring the arm all the way up, clamp it so it stays up so I can run the rod through the T-nut. And what I do is put just a little bit of white lithium grease on it. I put a little dab at the bottom, a little dab in the about a third up and then two thirds up. That way the grease will grease the T-nut and the rod at the same time. And then I just run that through. And if you feel any real serious burrs, now's the time to fix them, but you'll feel a little bit of resistance, but this thing should go pretty smoothly through the T-nut all the way down to the stepper motor. You can almost let go of this thing and it'll spin, but not quite. It's not that free spinning. But once I get it all the way down to the stepper motor, then I can push it into the stepper motor and tighten that up. So that should grease everything. So now I just can unclamp this and push it into the clamp. Now I'll tighten that screw up on the clamp, and we're ready to go. It's all back together, no more wobble, and the bed is really level. The springs themselves are about equal. And I ran my bed level test. I won't redo it here, but I'll put a link to it up here. But it came out really beautiful, nice and even. And like I said, the springs are about the same height. So it really worked, and this machine is ready to go. And if you're interested in that white lithium grease, I'll put a link to some in the description below, but you can find this at just about any hardware store.